Hi guys, David and David here from payitforward.com, and in this video we're going to explain what other is in iPhone storage.
So other can be a lot of different things. It's usually cached videos, pictures, and web pages. Mm-hmm. It could also be some miscellaneous system data or your Siri voices. Right. And unfortunately there's no magic button that says delete all this other on my iPhone, but there are a few tips we can recommend to you to start chopping away at it.
Right, and if David said cache photos, videos, and you didn't know what that means, what that means is that when you see a photo or a video on your iPhone actually saves a copy of that, even if it was like on a website, let's say, so that every time you go back to that same website, it doesn't have to re-download the same photo over and over and over again. Same concept with photos that you see in the Photos app and messages videos app, on iTunes and messages. Your iPhone saves data, so it doesn't have to keep re-downloading the same data over and over again. That's in the other app.
But on your iOS device, yeah, it will be deleted from your iOS device eventually.
According to Apple's website, your device automatically deletes those cached files when it needs more space. And they say, quote, you don't need to delete them yourself, unquote. But there are a lot of other things that you can do, and we're going to talk about that right now.
So the first thing to do is clear the Safari web history and data. Mm-hmm. Pretty simple. Right. Open the Settings app on your iPhone.
Yep.
Scroll down to Safari. Did I miss it? There it is. Mm-hmm. Scroll down here, tap clear history and website data, confirm. That's, you know, your browsing history, stuff like that.
Right, and all those pictures that you've seen on the internet that are now saved, so it doesn't have to re-download, can, you know, are now gone.
Yep.
And that can be huge.
Yep. So next, let's head over to iPhone storage and check out what some of their recommendations are. There are a lot of great built-in recommendations here.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll go back to the main page of the Settings app,
mm-hmm,
tap General, and then tap iPhone storage.
And we're both doing this because we both have some different recommendations, yep, on our iPhones. David said before that the Messages app has a big impact on this other thing, because every time somebody sends you a photo in the Messages app or a video, those are big files. And so if you're getting a lot of friends that are sending you photos, that can add up real fast. So on my iPhone, it says auto-delete old conversations. So I can save 913 megabytes by removing the messages and attachments that were sent or received over 1 year ago. But you know, I'd like to have a paper trail. And review large attachments, which was also a way to just go into that Messages app and take out just the biggest things, like the biggest photos, the biggest videos. And that's a relatively new feature, because what you used to have to do was just delete everything from the Messages app up until, let's say, 30 days ago. Mm-hmm. However, that's still a good idea for some people to turn in that setting. So I just want to show you that real quick. If you go back to General, and then back to Settings, and then scroll down to Messages, open that up, and then scroll down here to Keep Messages under Message History. Tap on that, and you can say, I just want to keep my messages for 1 year or for 30 days. If you choose 30 days or 1 year, obviously, mm-hmm, the older messages that happened a year ago, see you later. So that'll help to keep the other space on your iPhone.
Yep, nice and clear. So let's take a look at my iPhone storage real quick. Mm-hmm. iCloud Photos, I can save over 10 gigabytes by enabling iCloud Photos. That sounds, mm-hmm, like a good idea.
Mm-hmm.
I can also offload unused apps, which is actually our next tip in this video, is to offload the apps you aren't using.
Right, when you delete an app on your iPhone, all of the configuration, let's save a game, all your saved games, they're gone because you deleted the, mm-hmm, app.
Yep.
But when you offload the app, your iPhone saves your stuff in, yep, the app, and then it deletes the app itself, so you re-download it and works like it did before.
So here I can either enable offload unused apps, or I can go one by one down my list of apps here. This is what I actually kind of prefer, this method, mm-hmm, just in case my iPhone decides to offload something that I actually need in the future. So for example, I haven't used the DraftKings app in forever. I'm going to tap on that and then tap offload app, confirm offload app.
Right, so this app size of 150 megabytes is now gone.
Yep.
Sorry. High five. And documents and data of 13 kilobytes, that's like nothing. Yep. That would fit on a floppy disk.
So if I want to go back, just go back to the same spot and tap reinstall app, and that'd be right there.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're really concerned about the other in your iPhone storage, there is one more step you can take. We really don't think it's super necessary, but if you really want to get rid,
right,
of that,
this is if you have a problem,
yeah,
like a serious problem, and you need to get this other thing smaller, because Apple clearly says, and we clearly say, like, you don't need to worry about this if you have all this extra space in your iPad or iPhone. Just don't worry about it. Mm-hmm. Just stop watching this video right now.
Right, but if you are really worried, DFU Restore, yeah, is the way to go. First, back up your information on your iPhone,
yep,
and then from the DFU Restore. We'll leave a link in a card up above and the description section below. So that's what other is in iPhone storage, and those are a few tips you can use to really chop away at that other. Thank you guys for watching this video. Give it a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Leave us a comment down below. Let us know how much storage space you save from this video. If you have any other questions, also leave a comment below. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and click the notifications bell to get an immediate update when we upload a new video.
Thanks, brother.